हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ वीडियो 18 पार्ट 1 चैप्टर नंबर 3 एलिमेंट्स कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स फॉर क्लास 7। एट पेज नंबर 6 वी ऑलरेडी हैव स्टडीड अ लिटिल अबाउट एलिमेंट दैट इज अ सबस्टांस दैट कैन नॉट बी स्प्लिट इंटू सिंपलर सबस्टांसेस by a chemical means is called an element, and a substance that can be split into simpler substances by a chemical means is called a compound. So here we have third chapter, elements, compounds and mixtures, where we will study elements, compounds and mixture in detail. So as you know, everything is ultimately made up of elements, and two or more elements may chemically combine to form a compound. For example, both hydrogen and oxygen are element. So when two elements of hydrogen combines with one element of oxygen, then we will get water, H2O. So this water is compound. So we can say that two or more elements combine together to form a compound. So two or more elements may chemically combine to form a compound, but everything that we come across is not necessarily a pure element or pure compound. That is, in our surrounding, everything is not necessarily a pure element or pure compound. So it may be a mixture of elements, may be a mixture of compounds, or may be a mixture of one of element and compound. Underline, it may be a mixture of elements, a mixture of compounds, or a mixture of one of elements and compounds that do not react upon being mixed. For example, the air we breathe contains elements like oxygen and nitrogen, and compounds like carbon dioxide and water vapor. That is, air contains oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide, water vapor. So we can say that air is a mixture of elements, like molecule of an element oxygen and nitrogen. Similarly, air is a mixture of compounds like carbon dioxide and water vapor, or air is a mixture of element and compound. Now, substances are classified into pure substances and mixtures, and pure substances are further classified into elements and compounds. And firstly, we will study these pure substances in detail. Underline, definition. A pure substance is one that cannot be split into simpler substances. Underline, cannot be split into simpler substances by a physical means. Underline, physical means. So any substance that cannot be split into simpler substance by physical methods or by physical means. Physical methods like filtration, sublimation or distillation is called pure substance. Now, as we know that both elements and compounds cannot be split into simpler substances by physical means, so that's why they are called as pure substances. Both elements and compounds are called as pure substances because they cannot be split into simpler substances by physical means. So first of all, we will study about elements. Again, same definition here we have. An element is a substance that cannot be split into simpler substances by a chemical means. Underline, cannot be split into simpler substances by a chemical means. So here we have one point to note, that a substance which cannot be split by chemical means and also cannot be split by physical means is called as element. Underline, a substance which cannot be split by chemical means and cannot be broken down by physical means either is known as element. So elements are the substances that cannot be split by chemical means as well as cannot be broken down by physical means. Elements are represented by symbols. The symbol of an element consists of either the first or the first and one more letter of the English or Latin name of the element. These rules for writing the symbol of an element we already have studied in video 7, part 7. You can see that video for writing the symbol of an element. So here we have first point, that is the first letter in capital of the English name of an element. So for example, element hydrogen can be represented as capital H. So in order to write its symbol, we will use its first letter, but it should be in capital. So similarly, boron is represented by capital B, first letter in capital. Carbon by capital C, first letter in capital. Accordingly, nitrogen by capital N, oxygen by capital O, fluorine by capital F, phosphorus by capital P, and sulfur by capital S. Now, when first letter of an element is similar to that of another element, for example, first letter of helium is similar as that of hydrogen, then element can be written with two letters. First letter in capital and second should be smaller. So helium can be represented by capital H, small e. Similarly, neon, here capital N of neon is similar to that of nitrogen. So this neon is represented by capital N and small e. Similarly, nickel by capital N, small I, magnesium, capital M, small g, magnesium, capital M, small g, and manganese, capital M, small n, aluminium, capital A, small l, argon, capital A, small r. Similarly, calcium, Ca, chromium, Cr, cobalt, Co, chlorine, Cl, zinc, capital Z, small n, platinum, capital P, small t, and radium, capital R, small a. So if we use two letters to represent an element, then first letter should be capital and second letter should be smaller. Now symbols of few elements will be written according to their Latin name instead of their English names. For example, symbol of sodium is capital N, small a, instead of capital S. This is according to its Latin name, that is natrium, capital N, small a. And symbol for potassium is capital K, from its Latin name kalium. For iron, it is capital F, small e, from ferrum. For copper, it is capital C, small u, from cuprum. Silver, it is capital A, small g, from argentum. And for tin, it is SN, capital S, small n, from stannum. For gold, it is capital A, small u from iron. And for lead, it is capital P, small b from plumbum. And for mercury, symbol is capital H, small g instead of capital M because of its Latin name hydrogyrum. So, remember that the symbol of an element represents one atom of the element. Symbol represents only one atom of the element. Thus, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, iron and copper represent one atom of hydrogen. One atom of hydrogen represents capital H. Capital N represents one atom of nitrogen. Capital O represents one atom of oxygen. And capital Cl represents one atom of chlorine. Fe represents one atom of iron and Cu represents one atom of copper.